Hello, this is Alex and welcome back to the SMP Survival Vanilla server here. I had to hurry over here and start my recording because Seamus, as you may be able to tell, is out there. And he's AFK and you don't go AFK unpunished here. You know, he was just standing here with a few dirt blocks around him. So I was looking for him. I thought he was AFK in like a mob trap somewhere getting XP, but he's just standing here, and he's been standing here for like 45 minutes. So I came over here, completely encased him in blocks, and then put water all over the blocks, so when he comes back, if he ever comes back, he's gonna have a good time getting out of here. Yeah. You don't go AFK here, Seamus. Okay, I just wanted to go over here. See, he's actually built something here. I think it's a little fishing dock thingy. You can stand here and fish. It's very nice. I don't think he worked anymore on his hole in the ground. It still looks like a big hole in the ground. And his amazing house over here is still over here. So, yeah. But I'm going to go back to my base. We're going to do some... make an experiment today. And I'll meet you over there. Whee! Seamus put in tracks, finally. So, since last time I've been quite busy, as you might be able to tell. I wanted to try and put water over my house here. And I don't know if I like that. But it gave me another idea, which we're gonna get to. I also built this... Shut up, chickens. I also built this offshoot here. And we have another little bowl here with... there's a grass layer there. And water at the bottom. So let's go have a look at that. There we go. Go over here. And I put in some stairs here. We have the layers. I also put in a lot of chests. And I moved all my stuff from where it was before. So we got like gravel and all the blocks. And yeah, the goodies here. And old tools. Redstone, wood stuff, so on and so forth. You know how it goes. Mob drops, stuff from the Nether, all that. And I killed another two withers. I got three beacons here going all the way up. And it gives me speed, haste and jump. So yay for high jumping. I put in the, what's it called, furnaces over here. I think I'm gonna move them, I don't really like them here. I do have a bed, but yeah, since Seamus is AFK over there, I can't sleep. Over here, we have my two bunnies I got before, previous episode, I forgot to show you, but these are tamed, and if you don't tie them up, they actually follow you, and I don't want that. Then we have cows on this side, sheep over here, we got some foodstuffs for the animals over there. And we're gonna try a little experiment. So I'm gonna get set up for that and I'll be right back. Okay, first of all, I wanna see, I wanna remove this water on top of the house. You let me know if you like it. I actually like it quite a bit, but we're gonna do something today that's gonna collide with this. So I wanna remove it first and we can put it back later if we like it. I just need to remove all the water source blocks. I put over a lot of water source blocks up here to get it to spread all over. So I don't know exactly where they are, so we're just gonna do this. I think I put some, like, where was it? I've had to put some in the corner somewhere. Get there. Go away, water. I think I put one here, maybe. Or there, or both, there maybe? I think that was it. You, go away. Oh, I'm gonna run out of... Okay, I have to pick this up. Go away. I don't wanna break the glass. No, never know if I can remember where to put it again. There. Okay. Yeah, we got some there. There. Is that gonna go away now? I think that's gonna go away. Okay. Let's go see if we can have a look what it looks like. Jump. Get this. Oh, okay. Yeah, so all the water's gonna go away now. I made this bridge here. It's not pretty and it's not supposed to be. It's just a way to get over there because I didn't have a way in. I still have, I made an opening here. You may be able to tell there. So I could actually enderpearl in and out as I was clearing out all the chests from over here. And I moved the sheep and the cows up there. So we only have chickens there and the very noisy pigs there and the very noisy chickens over there. And all the chests here are gone. I moved them up there. Look at that. You can actually see the thing now. So we can enderpearl in through here. And I did this, ran back and forth, emptied the chest and brought it up here and sorted all the things. So, yeah. But you may also have noticed this like scaffolding all the way around here. And this, I want to show you what this is. First of all, I dug a trench all the way around my base here. This is exactly at the place where you lose the buffs. So if you go up one here, we get the buffs. And if I go down here, I'm going to lose them. So this is the cutoff point. So if you're within this trench, on this side of it, you're going to keep the buff. And I have this going all the way around. I cut off all the trees that hung over it. And you may be able to tell where this is going. If not, I'm going to explain in a second. So I have this going here, all the way around. Most of the trees I just cut down. Some of them I just shaved, like this one. And it continues there and up over the mountain over here. Let's see if we can get over there. Hello, piggy. Yeah, you can see. And the way you do this, or the way I've done this, is just to make sure that there's a block on each side of the trench block here. And this is because we don't want to have any spillage. And by spillage, I mean we don't want to have water going everywhere. Because, ow, that wasn't a fall. Don't put that on the counter. Someone is making a counter of how many times I fall. That's so mean. So up here, I built these towers first to measure out exactly where the beacons reach. And on the inside of this trench in these towers, you'll get the full effect of all three beacons. And on the outside, you will lose them, the effect of all three beacons, or at least one of them. And up here, I have a canal going all the way around with the water in it. And on the right side here, the one with the torches, this is going to stay. And the left side, or this outside here, I'm going to remove all of these blocks. And this is going to make the water flow over the edge and down here. And it's going to get caught in my trench, which is why I dug it. And the reason there's all these torches is because this point here where I'm standing is actually over this mountain. And this is an extreme hills biome, as you may be able to tell right here. And that means when it rains, it snows up here. And it freezes the water. And I don't want that. So I have these torches everywhere to stop the water freezing. And we need to be on this side of the water. I'm going to lose the sprint ability. But I have this all the way around. I put torches all the way around. This took quite a while. And I want to make like this box of water. And I want to see what it looks like. But to do that, I think I want to bring in my other account. See? So we can stand, for instance, here with my other account. And look, and I can be up there and break all the blocks, and we can see the water cascading down. And that's what I wanted to set up. But before I did that, I wanted to explain to you what I was doing. So I'm going to get that ready, and I'll see you shortly. Okay, so I'm on the other account now. Hooray! And yeah, I'm gonna go over there, like there, up there, and I'm gonna try and break the blocks. So I hope this works. The recording is always a little bit iffy when you have two accounts going on the same computer and you don't know which window Fraps is gonna record, but I hope this works. Otherwise, we're gonna have to do it again. And since I have the depth strider on my boots, hello, I'm trying to like wave. It's a little bit hard. Since I have the depth strata on my boots, I can actually run through the water at the same speed that I do if I don't have them. And another thing is that I have on my helmet, which you can't see right now. Oh, I'm falling down here. Get up. Okay, on my helmet I have I'm looking Aqua Affinity, so I mine at the same speed as I would if I didn't have it on. So I'm going to run over here to this corner and I'm going to mine out this block and I'm going to run backwards. So here we go. Wow, look at that. I'm looking at both screens now. I have two monitors. This looks very cool. Oh, shoot, I almost fell down. Okay, here we go. Continue. There was a little bit of hiccup there because I hit the ladder thing. Look at that. Oh, and get the last two. Wow. That looks cool, eh? And I'm not even getting any lag. Okay. Let's see if I switch. If I switch to this account and turn it over here. We can try it again here. That's good enough, I think. Okay, and I think that's this one here, right? Yes, okay, let's do it again. That looks so cool. It's like a water curtain coming down. I'm sorry about the jerky video when I switch between the accounts. I have to do this while I'm recording. But I think the effect is cool. Okay, switch over here to this account. This is coming down where I am. I'm up there. Okay, let's look here. And nope, that's not the thing I wanted to do. Alt tap, there we go. No! I broke the wrong thing. I'm gonna ruin everything. Oh no. I hope that doesn't screw up the water thing down there. If you get the water screwed up, it's gonna be hard to fix it. I'm looking at the water thing fall down. Okay. Let's continue this. Is it done falling? Yeah, kinda. Okay, let's go. Break this as well. I really like how this looks. This looks very cool, I think. By the way I'm doing this is in the Minecraft root folder on your computer. There's a file called options or something like that. And in there is a thing where you can tell it, do you want me to lose focus of the when you lose focus of the game, I mean if you tap out of it, do you want the game to pause? And I just set that to false. So when you alt tap out of the game, like I'm doing now, it doesn't bring up the pause menu like when you hit escape. Okay, gotta be a little bit careful over here because I might fall off the edge. So maybe I should run forward and do it instead. Yeah, that's better. There. Uh-oh, I'm getting swept off the edge now. Look at that. Okay, can I... Let's see if I can enderpearl into my cameraman's face here. Nope, that's not gonna be good. No? Oh, I failed. Let's try again. There, see my enderpearl. Come on. No, another fail. Come on, get it. Yes, yes, yes. Oh. It's so weird seeing stuff on two screens at once here. Okay, I'm gonna switch back to my real account here. Okay, I think I'm recording on my Slice DK account here. Where was it that the water fell down and I didn't want it to? I think it's over there. By the way, that's my camera guy. Hello, camera guy. Yoink, yoink. This is actually the first account I played with and I can't hit him. He is in creative mode. And once I started making YouTube videos and I made the account Slice DK, I created another account. Oh yeah, this is where the water fell down, but it didn't screw up anything. So I made another account, the SliceDK account I use now. Okay, so the water is kind of weird here on the corners, but that's okay. Let's pick up all of these. And I think it looks kind of nice. You tell me what you think. Oh, I lost the buff. Let's go over the side, get the buff, go back. Good, we can run fast again. I'm going to pick up all of these, or as many as I can. Wasn't actually that many, like half a stack. Oh, there's some over here. Most of them despawned, or at least on the side I was on first. Just because I was fiddling with the videos and testing out and seeing what would happen. So, of course, the game is just running and all of this stuff despawned. But it looks like my trench here caught the water. It's not running, you know, from here and down this mountain. I didn't want that. So, yes, okay, good. Hello, Mr. Fluffer guy. So I think I'm gonna make the pillars here in the corners instead of here in the middle. I don't know. And I thought about covering this entire thing with glass like I did in one of my earlier seasons. No, what's wrong with the water over here? Is this a graphical glitch, or is it supposed to look like this? I wanna go see what's up here. Oh, it just looks weird. It's okay, it's good. Yeah. And we're also gonna have by doing this we're gonna have a huge squid farm, because squids like to spawn. Oh well, they spawn at, what is it, 64 and down or something like that. I forget. But yeah, you let me know what you think of this, and also what you think of having the house covered with water. I think the reason why I removed it before I did this is because I think it would just disappear in all the water in the background. So a blue thing here on a blue background, I think it would just disappear, but I don't know. And also, if I should make, I think I'm going to make some more of those. Maybe make one that goes off on a diagonal here, but I don't know, because now I got all the chests up there, you know, and that may not work. So if I want to put one off on the diagonal here, I'd have to move all these chests. Or maybe we can do something up here. I don't know what to put up here actually yet. I haven't done anything. I just put in the stuff down here. So, hello bunnies. I'm actually gonna end the video here, because even though it may not be long, it took very long time to set up and execute. I played many hours to get to this point, as you may be able to tell. But I like to do that. I actually like to have something to show off before the next episode. One for you. One for you. Make me a little bunny. Oh, so cute. And he's gonna follow me and drown. I think this is like the fourth time I've bred those. And this little guy just follows me, and then he falls in the water and he can't get out. And he drowns. But yeah, such is life, I guess. So let's go over here. Oh no, that was my last one. That was stupid. Okay, but I'm gonna end it here like this. Thank you very much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed, and let me know what you think about all the things. Okay, see you next time. Bye.